thank these three poets for keeping you awake so that I could put you to sleep. This reading is a kind of experiment, and this poem is about the same experiment. And the experiment is sobriety. This is the first reading in about 17 years that I've given sober, and for that reason, it will probably be the worst. It may work, and I'll just keep doing it. And then maybe 50 years from now, I will be alive. There's some references here. Palacio, well, this poem takes place in Barcelona, where I lived many years ago. And Palacio Güell is one of Gaudí, the architect Gaudí's earlier and awful buildings. Some of the late stuff is fantastic. Modernismo was the art movement that he was identified with. Valle Inclán was a Spanish poet of the early 20th century who translated Edgar Allan Poe. And Gabriela Mistral was one of the worst poets ever to win the Nobel Prize. And I think that's a considerable. I would like to be the worst poet ever. That's one of my ambitions. It's called Black Wine. Have you ever drunk the black wine, Vino Negro, of Alicante? The English dubbed it Red Bitty and consumed oceans of it for a pence of flag. Knowing nothing then or now about wine, I would buy a liter for 8 pesetas, 12 cents, and fry my brains. Being a happy drunk, I lived a second time as a common laborer, toiling all night over the classic strophes I burned in the morning, literally burned in an oil barrel outside the Palacio de Güell, one of the earliest and ugliest of Gaudí's monuments to modernism. 5 mornings a week, the foreman, Antonio, an Andalusian with a voice of stone raked over corrugated tin, questioned the wisdom of playing with fire. He'd read Edgar Allan Poe in the translations of Valle Inclán and believed the poets of the New World were madmen. Yes, even the women were madmen. He claimed an affair with Gabriela Mistral was the low point of his adolescence. As the weeks passed into spring and the plane trees in the courtyard of the ancient hospital burst into new green, I decided one morning to test sobriety, to waken at dawn to sparrow chirp and dark clouds blowing seaward from the Bull Taco factory, to inhale the particulates and write nothing, to face the world as it was. Antonio was as disappointed as I. Everything was actual. My utterances drab. My lies formulary and unimagined. For the first time in my life, I believed everything I said. Think of it. Simple words in English or Spanish or Yiddish. Words that speak the truth and no more. Hour after hour, day after day without end. A life in the kingdom of candor without fire or wine.